Hello there.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Better now.
Nice to see you. It is a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, my buddy.
Oh, well, your name is as difficult as mine.
Mine is Anthony Van.
Now, that's a name I can handle.
I'm Sina.
Sina Ileana. Thank you. Well, come on over. Hi, guys.
Well, first, we wanted to thank you for this appointment.
Thank you.
It gives us an opportunity to share with you some of the stories of individuals, the kinds of narratives that you might not get from all of the statistics about the Baha'is.
Absolutely. That's so important.
And so we also wanted to thank you for all of the support that you provided in the past. We know that you have such a keen interest in religious freedom, not just the case of the Baha'is, but all sorts of people everywhere.
I'm the brother of Fariba Kamalabadi, who is one of the two women on the National Ad Hoc Administrative Committee of the Baha'i community in Iran, who were arrested. Six out of the seven members were arrested. And at the time of their arrest, it was as part of an organized and synchronized effort on the part of government officials to raid the homes of the six members remaining. At the same time, an early day of May 14th of that year.
My name is Kamal Khanjani, and my brother's name is Jamaluddin Khanjani, which is one of the members of Yaran. And he was incarcerated the same time with some other members. And after investigation in their house and pick up the possess, like a DVD, video, CD player, CD or some other.
So they follow the same kind
exactly.
of pattern. You know,
exactly.
They go through all the house
after
to try to find something or just incriminate
exactly.
them anyway.
After a few hours, took my brother in the Evin prison, and as well as some other member of the Yaran, find out where he is, how he is, because of solitary confinement.
Well, you already heard the story from Mr. Kamalabadi
yes.
and Khanjani. And I just want to share that, you know, every these individuals are the mother and the father. And
yes.
it's so heartbreaking
oh.
that they can't spend time, you know, with their family. And my nephew is 13
years
old.
And that you don't know, how old is he?
13.
13.
Yeah, and the last 2.5 years, you know, his father is not
right.
there. Even though he's trying his best from the prison and through letter and poem, still have that relationship with them, but it's really
it's
frustrating
hard.
And
it's
very
terrible.
Hard for the
it's a tragedy.
Kids. So we are hoping meeting with you and others with the help.
You have a lot of friends here, as you know. Frank Wolf, Chris Smith, you have so many friends. Joe Pitts, a
so
lot of friends.
And bring so much joy to their heart that they know they're not
you are not that. Alone.
Thank
and
you
make
so
sure
much.
That they know in their cells they are not alone.
Thank you.
My cousin, Raha, has been in solitary confinement for the majority of these, her term so
solitary
far.
Solitary confinement.
And, you know, she has developed some health issues. So for that, she has to leave the prison on a regular basis for medical treatment. Actually, a few times, you know, we got to talk when she was out for the medical treatment, and she expressed how much she wished she was out of prison so she could continue serving her
yes.
countrymen and those children, and how, you know, she prays every day for the people, all the people of the world, to be able, you know, to work together to make a better world. And she's been active, you know, writing letters and documents to the officials of Iran about justice and human rights for all Iranians, not only Baha'is, for everyone.
Absolutely, and I was just going to say that, you know, the numbers make a difference, and when you have solidarity among groups. So it's great that you do outreach, you know, with all the different groups and all the religious minorities and non-religious groups who are imprisoned in Iran or anywhere,
yeah.
And find that commonality, and that's very important. And I look forward to working together with you as we put together that hearing on religious
right.
persecution. Thank you. You are not alone, and your sister's
you
not
so
alone, and your cousins are not alone. They're not alone.
Thank
and
you
we,
so much.
We hear them, and we hear their anguished cries for help.
Congresswoman, as a matter of fact, I've been talking to my sister about this upcoming meeting with you, and you won't believe how ecstatic she was knowing that there is hope on the other side of the world.
That is
that
amazing.
Their voice and their sacrifices.
Well, you know, this morning I was speaking to Natan Sharansky, a man of the Jewish faith from the old Soviet Union, and he said, you know, in his gulag in Siberia, they thought that they were alone until they heard about the impact they were having in the West, and speeches that members of Congress were making in the English Parliament, and you name it, and everybody. And he said, even in your solitary cell, you know that someone's listening.
Yes.
So
thank you so much,
ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.